Hey, what's up everybody, and welcome back to our tutorial series on Jenkins. In the last video, I showed you how to create a Jenkins job for a simple Maven project. And our Jenkins server has no problem running this job or really any of the jobs that we've created in the previous videos. But in a corporate environment, Jenkins jobs might consume a significant percentage of resources on the machine that's hosting the Jenkins server, especially when there are many jobs ran in parallel. So let's take a look at our next topic that will help mitigate this challenge. In this video, we are going to configure Jenkins Controller and Jenkins Agent nodes. And before I walk you through the configuration steps, I first want to discuss the problem that we're trying to solve. As software teams and their organizations grow, so does the need to scale Jenkins. In addition, software teams may need to build and test software on multiple platforms, like Windows, Mac OS, and Linux. And a single Jenkins instance will likely be unable to meet these requirements. In order to meet these requirements, we must scale Jenkins up and or out. Jenkins can support organizational growth as well as the need for multi-platform build and testing through the use of agents. Jenkins agents are machines that the Jenkins controller can delegate the task of building projects to in a distributed manner. An agent node might be a Windows machine, a Linux machine, or some other platform that supports Java. This allows multi-platform build and testing using the same Jenkins server. And it also allows us to scale our Jenkins out as needed. All we need to do is add additional agent nodes. If we take a look at the architecture shown here, the Jenkins controller node is the Jenkins server that we've already configured in previous videos. We will be adding a Windows agent node in this video. After we've configured our Jenkins agents, the Jenkins controller will be able to schedule builds on Jenkins agents according to the Jenkins job configuration. Now that we've covered those details, let's get started. So the first step to set up our Jenkins controller and Jenkins agent nodes is to create an SSH key pair. I have my terminal up already. I'm using git bash, and in git bash, I'm going to use the SSH key gen command to generate a new key pair. And I'll call it Azure Jenkins agent. And I'll leave the passphrase empty. Okay, so that generated a new key pair, and I'm going to cat the private key. And I'm going to copy the contents of the private key. And then I'm going to navigate to Jenkins. And in the Jenkins controller, I'm going to navigate to manage Jenkins. And then we'll navigate to manage credentials. We'll open up the Jenkins credential store and then global credentials. And then I'm gonna select add credentials. And then the kind of credential that we're gonna use is SSH username with private key. And we'll give it an ID. We'll say it's Azure Jenkins agent. And the username is going to be Azure user, and then the private key will enter directly, and I'll just paste the private key into that field. Okay, and then I'll select OK. The next step is to copy our public key to the machine that is going to be our Jenkins agent hosted in Azure, and I already have an SSH session open with that machine, so I'm going to open up that session. And I'm currently on the logged on to the machine or the VM that will be running as a Jenkins agent. And I'm going to modify the authorized keys file and add the public key that we just created. Okay. So in the other terminal window, I'm going to cat the public key. And I'll copy the public key value. And I'll add this public key to the authorized keys list. And then we will save that file. So now we should be able to SSH, or this Jenkins instance should be able to SSH to this VM hosted in Azure. So we can begin configuring this Azure VM as a Jenkins instance inside of our Jenkins controller. So I'm going to navigate back to the Jenkins dashboard. And from here, I'm going to navigate to Manage Jenkins. And then I'm going to select Manage Nodes and Clouds. So we're going to create one additional node, and I'm going to use this Windows PC as the second node. So I'm going to select New Node, and we'll call it Windows Agent. I'll select Permanent Agent, even though I do have the option to copy from an existing node. And I'll select OK. I'll leave the number of executors at 1, and then I'll use the same remote root directory. I'll just call it Jenkins Agent Data. And for labels, I'll use the Windows label. Usage, I'll leave usage as default. And then the launch method, we'll use launch agent by connecting it to the master. And one reason, besides just to demonstrate this launch method, one other reason to use this launch method is because this Windows PC is on my home network. And the Azure VM has a public IP, and it's accessible. So I can use the SSH connect to via SSH in that case, because port 22 is open and the IP for that Azure VM is public. But for this Windows PC, the IP address is not public. And by using this launch method, I can start the agent program locally and then specify the IP address of the controller and establish a connection, an outbound connection to the controller that way, since the controller does have a public IP address. I'll leave the rest of the configurations for this launch method as default. Same for the availability. And then I'll select Save. So now you can see that the Windows agent has been added, but there is an X over the node indicating that Jenkins is not connected with it. And if we click on the agent, it says that the JNLP agent port is disabled and agents cannot connect this way. And it even tells us where we need to go to update the configuration so that this works correctly. So I'm going to follow this hyperlink. And this takes me to the global security page of Jenkins. And if I scroll down to the agents section, I have to enable a TCP port for inbound agents. And I can select random or fixed, and I'm going to select fixed. And I'm going to enter a high value port number that I know is not being used. And then I'm going to select save. Now I'll select Manage Nodes and Clouds, and I'll select the Windows agent again. And now you can see that it tells us at the top we can connect to the agent using one of these ways. And the first, we can run from the agent command line this command. And this is the command that we're going to use to run the agent program on this Windows PC. So I'm going to copy this command to my clipboard. And I'm going to download the agent.jar file locally. And now that we have that downloaded, I'm going to open up a Git bash session. And I'll navigate to the directory where the agent.jar file was downloaded. And I'm going to paste the command into the session, and we'll run it and see if the agent connects successfully. Okay, and it looks like it did connect. It says that it's connected right there. So I'll refresh the page, and it says that the agent is connected. I'll navigate back to the dashboard. We'll create a new item. and we'll call it test Windows agent. I'll select freestyle project. And then I'll select restrict where this project can be ran. And I'll use the Windows label this time. And in the build section, I'm going to add a single build step, execute shell. And we'll say echo hello world to hello world.txt. And we'll select save. And then let's go ahead and build this job. Okay, so I'll navigate into the job console output. And you can see at the top of the console output, it's building remotely on the Windows agent using the Windows label. And then it specifies the workspace that it's using on my local Windows PC. And it looks like it was successful with the echo command as well. We can quickly verify that in Git Bash. So if I cd to downloads, and then Jenkins agent data, I'll cd into the workspace, and then I have the job directory. And if I cd into the job directory, we can see the hello world .txt file did get created. And if I cat that, the hello world is in that text file. If you'd like to learn more, be sure to follow our blog at lambdatest.com/blog, as well as our LambdaTest community at community.lambdatest.com. You can also earn resume-worthy LambdaTest Selenium certifications at lambdatest.com/certifications. So I will see you in the next video.